With a beautiful weekend ahead, how does spending your Saturday supporting local businesses and taking in some art sound? Should sound pretty good, right? Kara Rogers with the Downtown Escondido Business Association is with us this morning to give us a preview of Art Walk on Grand Avenue. Kara, thank you for joining us this morning.
Thank you for having us.
So I want you to start off by telling us about Grand Avenue itself and then walk us through what you have around you, because you have a pretty cool setup with you.
We do. So first of all, Grand Avenue, we have a historic downtown here in Escondido. And the Downtown Business Association works really hard to bring people here and share our eclectic mix of art and businesses and restaurants. We're very proud of our downtown.
And tell me about that you said you have some blown glass in front of you, right? From your studio, is that right?
We do, yes. This blown glass that's right here in front of me is from the studio that my husband and I own here in Escondido. It's Stone and Glass. We have a variety of things to represent some of what we'll have here tomorrow. And this is just one of the things that we'll have at the art show. We're going to have painters. We have Suki Lebo with us today, who does these fabulous miniatures. I love her work. She's one of my favorite artists here in Escondido. And so you see these wonderful little sculptures, paintings. They're just, I love them.
Those are so cool. I love all the setup.
Yeah. So she'll have a booth here on Grand tomorrow morning. The art show will run from 10 to 4. We are in the blocks on Grand Avenue that run from Broadway to Juniper. And we're kind of sprinkled in. You'll notice behind me, you'll see all the tents with different restaurants' names on them and so forth. The artists are sharing the street with those restaurant tents. So our hope is that you'll come, you'll have a meal here in Escondido, you'll walk the art show, enjoy the art, maybe buy some art while you're waiting for your table or working off that fabulous meal you had.
And tell us about, you have those barriers behind you that are decorated. Who's been decorating those barriers? What's kind of the idea behind those?
So what happened with those barriers, that project started very early in the pandemic as a way to brighten our lives with art here in Escondido. And Suzanne Nicolaisen, that is working here with putting QR codes on the barrier, and the Escondido Art Association led the effort to bring the community out to paint these barriers. Some of these are painted by professional artists. Some were painted by families that just volunteered to do a barrier, and different groups would come together. We even did one where city officials came in and painted the barrier, and it just is a way to launch the project. So what we're really excited about now is, as I said, Suzanne is putting QR codes on here. We, with the city, have developed a self-guided virtual tour. You can click on the QR code. It will tell you about the artist and what the artist was thinking when they painted it. And you can just walk down the street and hear the story of how we, you know, brought more art to Grand Avenue. I tell you, and we have more projects coming. I could talk to you about art forever, art in downtown Escondido.
I love it.
It's my heart and it's my passion, as it is with everyone else here.
And that's awesome. It's a great idea. Those barriers, as you mentioned, kind of came along early. Before we go, I want you to tell me, I mean, I know a lot of people are now looking to support local as the pandemic is starting, you know, things are starting to let up and open up once again. Tell us the importance with what you guys have been through as far as the small businesses go over the last year or so.
Well, yeah. So small businesses, as you've heard in the news, had a little bit more trouble getting help from the government. Because we're small, we got less money, and it kept us going for a shorter period of time than larger companies. So what we've had to do as small businesses is we have to get creative. So doing these shows where we come out of our studios and we're saying, hey, here we are, and remember that my studio is down the street, We need your support today at the art show, but we want you to remember us when you need gifts for your family, when the holidays come, because without our customers, we won't be here.
Right.
You know, it's like we say it's stone and glass. Thank you for fueling our flame. Our customers are the only reason that we get to make art. And it's the same way with retail.
Carol, we're running out of time here. We've got to wrap things up. Yep, but I want to thank you so much for being with us. 10 to 4, you mentioned, and more information is on your screen there at downtownescondido.com.
Yes.